No, not that.
Why not?
Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Jonathan Creamer.
And we're here in historic downtown Franklin, Tennessee at Gray's on Main to bring you five things that Kubernetes can do for you. Number one, what the heck is Kubernetes?
Yeah, it sounds like something you would buy for like your toddler or something, doesn't
right,
it?
Like a like set of blocks, right? Play with these Kubernetes blocks.
Well, Kubernetes is an amazing tool by Google. A lot of people are already using Docker in their infrastructures these days, either for local development reasons or for continuous integration reasons. But it's kind of difficult to take those containers you've built and put them out on the internet for people to use. So Kubernetes helps with that. It helps make scaling easier. It helps deploying all those things out and allowing people to use the containers that you've spun up.
So it's something that helps you manage your different
containerized
containers.
Workloads. Yeah, it could be apps, could be services. Doesn't matter what it is. Just helps take them and put them out there.
Nice.
And then like one server may run lots of different apps, and they kind of are able to automatically scale themselves.
Dude, we're not right now. I'm in the middle of an interview. Oh my gosh, that's so depressing. Number two, Kubernetes can help scale, which is great, right? Like everyone wants to scale.
Who doesn't want scale?
Scaling is the most
Kubernetes
important
Kubernetes is web scale.
Yeah, it's cloud scaling.
Yes, well, so seriously though, it just makes things easy to deploy and scale up, because rather than having like an application per server, you have like a pool of servers to run a lot of different things on. And the manifest file you write, you can determine how many pods you need for a given application. And you can easily just run one command and like spin up another pod or take them down as needed. It just makes it really easy. So whereas like we like to talk about scale, it just makes things very, very simple to scale.
So in the unlikely or likely event that you have the very good problem of needing more scale,
yes.
Kubernetes makes it very easy to get that.
Yes, very, very easy.
Nice. Number three, Kubernetes can help you speed up your deployments. Can you be more specific about that?
Yeah, sure. So like what we have at Lonely Planet is basically we have Jenkins set up to where when you merge code into master, Jenkins kicks off a Kubernetes build, and I can have code from my local machine up to the production servers. Obviously, this is partly due to Docker as well, but I can have those containers get built and stood up and distributed out to my customers in like 5 minutes.
Wow.
So I'm not sitting there waiting for like for packages to be installed all over the place. Because of the fact that Kubernetes is built around Docker, it just helps make things really, really fast. So I can iterate really quick, and if there's a bug, I can fix it really quick, so I'm not sitting there waiting for my servers to deploy things.
That is really, really nice.
Yes.
I didn't realize that Kubernetes sped up deployments that much, but that makes sense because you're deploying containers,
yes,
not applications,
right.
And that's one of the core benefits of containers.
And especially because of the, like, you don't have to wait for an NPM to install because that layer in your Docker image can be cached.
Right.
So if it's just a code change, that code change.
You know what I like to do? I like to run NPM install and then go get a sandwich, call my mom, take a nap,
come
back, see if it's
done.
Run
to the store.
Right.
Yeah.
Get things
done.
It's
shopping.
A good time to get errands taken care of.
Yeah. Definitely. Number four, you can use Kubernetes on Azure.
That's right, Jonathan. Actually, yes, the new AKS service allows you to use Kubernetes on Azure. It's free to use, so you only pay for what you use. Don't pay for the actual management of the cluster, which is super nice.
That is nice.
And again, like you said, you know, these allows you to easily scale out over all of the different Azure servers. We have several servers.
Well, not having to manage your own cluster would be a nice feature, because I know that that can be a pretty daunting task.
Right.
There's a lot to set up. And like if your server goes down or something, having to spin it back up is hard. So that's
right.
Nice.
And so they do automated updates for you, and it's self-healing. So those are the kinds of things that you might
very
not
nice.
Want to manage. If that's your jam, then Azure can help you with that using AKS. Number five, Kubernetes can really help simplify the management of your microservices infrastructures.
Yeah, that's very true. And a lot of that's due in part just to how Docker works and the fact that Kubernetes is, you know, kind of relying on Docker. You can basically have like a Node app or an Elixir app or a Python app running inside of a container, and it makes it really easy to just kind of ship whatever. You don't have to set up different...
You want my credit card? Can you hold this?
Yeah, sure.
Just hold this here.
Okay.
Just hold that. All right.
Hey, man. So anyway, microservices with Kubernetes become a lot easier to manage because Docker helps you distribute those containers and you don't have to set up servers to run your backend or your front end. It's just all Docker.
Because you're not working with operating systems right. anymore, so
yep.
you don't have to worry
exactly.
about that.
So your container just does everything for you. You could just download the Nginx container from Docker Hub and spit it out in Kubernetes and have an API gateway that abstracts to all your servers that run in containers.
Man, that's nice.
And then again, you can deploy really fast, so if something goes wrong, you can...
I was skeptical about Kubernetes, but I'm going to buy it now. How much is it?
It's open source, which is...
Really?
Yeah.
It's
Google
free.
Released that. Yeah. And there's a lot of people you should...
I'll take two Kubernetes.
I want two Kubernetes. Make sure you follow Kelsey Hightower on Twitter okay. to find out more information about it. He's one of the kind of core contributors to it. Definitely check it out. It makes... You know, I'm just an engineer, so I don't actually set up the orchestration of it.
You're just a lowly
engineer.
But
you can tell... Yeah, just an engineer. But... it makes just doing things so much easier as an engineer. Our DevOps team set it all up, and now for me, I just get to deploy things whenever I want,
nice.
Really quickly, and I don't have to...
That's what we want as engineers,
yeah,
right?
Just
to deploy things
right?
willy-nilly.
Ship code all the time.
Get out of my way.
Continuous
right.
everything.
Yeah. I'm Burke Collin.
And I'm Jonathan Creamer.
And I'm Elijah Manor.
Oh. Hey, man, your interview's next. We'll do this in a second.
All right, I'll be back.
All right, see you then. And now you know five things that Kubernetes can do for you.